Hare Krishna. The mind is omnivorous. It devours whatever is present and feels pleasant. Omnivorous creatures are indiscriminate. They eat vegetarian food, they eat plants where plants are available, and they eat flesh and animals where animals are available. So, our mind is indiscriminate like that. Our mind, whatever is present before it and whatever feels pleasant, it eats that. Just as an omnivorous creature or omnivorous people, they do not have any discerning sense about what is to be eaten or what is not to be eaten. If something tastes good and something is available, they eat it. The mind operates on the same principle, that whatever stimuli are present before it, it sees something attractive, it hears something musical, it smells something fragrant. So of course the mind does all this through the senses, but it is the mind which takes in and senses or feels the inputs coming in from the senses. So whichever input is placed before the mind, it gets carried away by that and it consumes that. So in that sense, our mind is omnivorous. And if something comes before, something it focuses on, by seeing it in the pathway of the senses, it gets carried away by that. So the Bhagavad-Gita warns us about this nature of us to be get captivated. When in 2.67 it says, Indriyanam hi charatam yanmano anuvidhiyate tadasya harati pragyam vayurnavamivambhasi. So indriyanam hi charatam, that the senses are roaming, and yanmano anuvidhiyate, and when the mind focuses on something which is seen by the senses, something that is present in the range of the senses, and it feels pleasant, tadasya harati pragyam, that steals our intelligence, vayurnavamivambhasi, this is the wind is swept away, this is the wind sweeps away a boat. So the point is, because our mind is omnivorous, we have to be careful about what stimuli we present before it. So if we take the endeavor to ensure that sensory degrading stimuli are not present near us, and if we surround ourselves with purifying, uplifting, divine stimuli, then if they are those stimuli are presented in an attractive way, the mind will get attracted to them. So thus, if we try to create a spiritual culture around us, if we try to have spiritual friends around us, if we surround ourselves with spiritual books, spiritual music, spiritual images, then the mind, because that is what is present and that is what also feels pleasant, there are many spiritual stimuli that's also enjoyable, and the mind will start consuming them, and as it consumes them, it will become purified. So knowing the omnivorous nature of the mind, if we are vigilant enough to keep only non-carnivorous food, that means herbivorous food, that means we keep only pure stimuli, and the mind will eat those stimuli and gradually become purified. So it is, rather than condemning the mind for getting captivated by anything and everything, we need to check the mind, we need to monitor the mind. And when we monitor the stimuli that are present before the mind, then the mind will consume the right stimuli and will become purified. Thank you. Hare Krishna.